second or another minute, not an hour or another day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, I need you to make a way as you have done so many times before. Through a window or an open door, I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. I need you now, I need you now, I need you now, I need you now. Not another second, another minute, not an hour of another day, but Lord, I need you right away. If I never needed you before to show up and restore all of the faith that I left slip while I was yet searching the world for more, the truest friend I have indeed. You're my best friend, I know in need. I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. Doing things on my own, the tests and trials that come to make me strong, the feelings of guilt, hurt, shame, and defeat, the ways of trials that beat upon me. But to know, Lord, that not another minute, Lord. Can't wait another day. Oh, oh Lord. Please make a way. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord. Thank you.
always here. And knowing that to be absent from the body,
Lord.
It means to be present with the Lord.
Amen.
Yeah, Lord.
We live for this day. Paul said to live is Christ.
Yes, Lord.
And to die is gain.
Yes, Lord.
We are in the land of the dying.
Yeah, Lord.
On our way to the land of the living.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Lord.
Brother Brown has outran us.
All right now.
All right.
But I can assure you, if you live right,
come on.
All right.
If you know Jesus,
that's right.
And the pardon of your sin, then we'll meet him again. Heaven is a prepared place for prepared people, and I'm not worried about Roy Lee because he knew where he was going.
All right.
Come on, man. Amen.
There's no doubt in my mind.
Yeah.
He made it in. So weep if you must. Shed those tears. The shortest verse in all of the Bible consists of two words. Jesus wept. And he cried because he cared.
Yeah.
Amen. So it's all right to shed tears.
Yeah.
We weep not as if there's no hope, because our hope is in Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
We know you're a child of God if you're a true saint. We know that if this earthly house of this tabernacle is dissolved, we have another building.
Yeah.
Not made by the hands of man. So today, Roy Lee Brown is just another soldier.
Yeah.
On his way home. So today we don't say goodbye, Roy Lee. We say see you later.
Yeah.
Rest on in Jesus. I fought a good fight. I've kept the faith. I finished my course. And now there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day. And not to me only, but unto all them that love his appearance. We loved our brother, we loved our deacon, but God loved him best.
Oh, yes.
At this time now, I will not prolong the service by reading the order of service. We do have a printed program, so we ask that the scripture readings will come followed by selection, and then we'll have the prayer.
Obedience. We read Psalms 121, verses 1 through 8. I'll be reading the King James Version. If you can stand. The Bible declares to us from Psalms 121, verses 1 through 8, it says, I will lift up my eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor by night, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in from time forward and even forevermore. May the Lord bless your eyes and ears on this day. New Testament reading. Revelation chapter 14, verse 13. Then I heard a voice from heaven say, write this, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from now on. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labor, for their deeds will follow them, harvesting the earth and trampling the winepress. May our blessing be to the hearers and doers of God's holy and blessing word.
With the Lord.
Father God, we ask that you would lift up this family
time that a man can have in life is when he dies and he does not know Jesus. But we can attest that Brother Brown didn't only know him, he loved him.
Yes.
He celebrated him.
Yes.
He held him up.
Yes.
He walked with him and talked with him.
Yes.
And so, Father, we know that in those midnight hours, Father, when he cried to you, you heard him.
Yes.
And God, the selfish part of us, said, stay a little bit longer. But God will say that you needed him now.
Yes.
And his voice, he must come. So, Father God, we thank you for a life well lived. And Father God, we hope and pray that when he got to the gates, you said to him, well done, well done, well done, my good and faithful servant. Come on up a little bit higher, for you have pleased God. So, Father God, we ask that when the funeral is over, and we all have dispersed back to our homes and all back to our lives, that we would remember this family in the days to come, in the weeks to come, in the months to come. Remember to reach out and just tell them that we're praying with you, that we love you, and we stand
here.
Father God, these and all blessings, we ask in your name. And for the sake of me and many others, I do pray. Let all those who love the Lord say amen.
Oh, contributed to the family of Brother Roy Brown from the George Washington Carver class of 1967. Why do we mourn departed friends or shake at death's alarm? 'Tis but the voice that Jesus sends to call them to his arms. This is just another soldier gone to get the great reward. He fought the fight, he kept the faith, and now he has gone home to God.
Let our farewell then be fearless, since I bid farewell to tears. Write this day of my departure festive in your coming years. Whereas the passing of Deacon Roy Lee Brown Jr. brings sadness and grief to his family, it has also brought the same to the church family, which especially includes the church's deacon ministry and Sunday school department. We pray that the family will find comfort and consolation in the words of Jesus who said, "Cast your burdens on him, for earth had no sorrow that heaven cannot heal." Whereas Deacon Brown left his home state of Louisiana to pursue opportunities in others, he never forgot from whence he came. Deacon Brown, known to many of his friends and acquaintances as Nick, had a love for all humanity that could never be surpassed. Whereas Deacon Brown was raised in a Christian family where his father served as chairman of the Deacon Ministry, superintendent and teacher of the Sunday School, and his mother as superintendent and teacher of the Sunday School and deaconess, his upbringing never left him. Deacon Brown followed in his parents' footsteps. He too became a deacon, Sunday school teacher, and superintendent. Deacon Brown's favorite words at the church was, "God's been good to me." And for Sunday school, his word, "This is a good lesson today." Therefore, be it resolved that Pastor Christopher Arduin Sr. and the officers and members of the Second Union Baptist Church extend to the family and friends our heartfelt sympathy. We bow in humble submission to the will of God, and we lift you in prayer during your time of bereavement. We commit the spirit of our brother, Deacon Morley Brown Jr., into the hands of the Almighty God, who is too wise to err and too just to make a mistake. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy to be held by the church for its records, prayerfully and humbly submitted on this 12th day of May, 2024, Second Union Baptist Church, Bundy, Louisiana, Reverend Christopher R. Duan, Senior Pastor, Brother Richard Malvo, Chairman of the Deacon Ministry, Sister Lillian P. Williams, Church Secretary. The family wishes to acknowledge, which I have received, 5 sympathy cards, 10 floors. With heartfelt gratitude, the family of Brother Brown would like to express heartfelt gratitude to everyone for every thoughtful gesture, smile, prayers, and kind words of encouragement during this time. You are greatly appreciated. The outpour of your efforts and love shown hasn't gone unnoticed. We would also like to send a special thanks to the staff of St. Patrick Hospital, St. Francis Cabrini Hospital, Rapids General Medical Center, Bunky General's Emergency Room, Bunky Dialysis Center, Heston Nursing Home, Heart of Hospice, Annie P. Kelly, A.U. Washington, Angelique Poston, and Janice Ward, the family of Roy Lee Brown Jr.
Some good days,
I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days and some sleepless nights. But when I look around, and I think things all of my out of my mind, that day best.
being able to know Mr. Roy. Hallelujah. It may have been for a short time, but I knew him. Hallelujah. Come on and give the Lord a hand. He's still worthy. He's still worthy. He's still worthy of the praise. He's still worthy to be given glory. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
I'm Deacon Robert Johnson. Brown, I came to pay tribute to you. Brown was one of my good friends, one of my deacon brothers. It was a place that I went to when I needed help. Because we can't fight it, y'all. When I was going to my turn on or something like that, I called on Brown. I get on the phone and call on him. And he'll look in the Bible and Ecclesiastes. There's the time for everything.
Yes.
I don't know about the times I read it. Lift me up.
Yeah.
So, Brown, you go ahead and take your rest.
You
love me, God love you best.
Superintendent and an assistant superintendent in place because that's how much he was the garden where and his spirit and son's food was intact. He was always the first one here, the only man here, and the first one here to open the doors for all of us ladies. And we all came in, and we knew Roy had our back. Because we loved Roy, and he loved us, and we all did. I did, wouldn't it? Roy loves everybody.
Yes.
How can you love everybody? He loved all of his class. And he loved because he loved God.
Yes.
God loved
yes.
him.
Yes.
So he had love all over him. Everybody, all his friends, all his church members, everybody, and family. Lord, love God. We all know that. And he believed in this Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord believed in that. So Lord loved the church, and he loved his family. And we all loved him. And before the beginning and ending of Sunday school, we would always say, oh, what a beautiful lesson it was. Every lesson was beautiful to Roy. And I would say, every lesson was beautiful to Roy. And I know now because every lesson is beautiful. That's something to learn. The knowledge behind every lesson. You don't just come here and just talk to have a lesson, but then we all get something out of the lesson.
Yes.
And that's the purpose. And
yes.
Roy's biggest wish was that the whole church
yeah.
would participate in Sunday school. You see, it's just only a few of us that come. But the whole Sunday school is about the whole church.
Yeah.
The whole church should participate.
Yeah, right.
So we love Roy dearly. We were all been missing for a long time. Because he was a part of us. And we'll never forget Roy. So rest in peace, my friend and my brother in Christ.
Amen.
Thank God.
Baptist Church Sunday School, to me, the most important department at the church, which is the church at school.
Huh.
To the family, you have our deepest self-felt sympathy. Brother Brown will be truly missed.
Yes.
So that Jehovah smile, that never meet a stranger attitude, and most importantly, that love for people. If you do not know Christ, pardon of your sins, if you have not met him as a personal Savior, we recommend Jesus.
Yes.
For he can do what no other can do.
Yes.
He gives the lily of the valley.
Yes.
He gives the wheel in the middle of the wheel.
Yes.
And he is truly the bright and morning star.
Yes, yes.
Family, we recommend Jesus.
Yes.
He who said, lo, I am with you always. Will walk with us in the hereafter, as he has walked with us in the shadows here below. Family, we recommend Jesus.
Yes.
When the curtain goes down in our lives, we expect to meet Brother Brown in that afterworld and to find him joyfully working for his master there, just as he worked for us at the church here. For he did not let the sun go down on them because he loved his Jesus. But we can only meet him if we die in Christ.
Yes.
So once again, family, we recommend to you Jesus.
Yes.
That the reference for And I think all the rest of them, he was so faithful and he was so honest and he always had a kind word and one for everybody. Like you're in conversation, if he can help people.
Yes.
He has a beloved spirit. And one of his favorite scriptures, was John 14. And when I spoke with his sister yesterday and she was telling me about it, said that he was ready to go. See, when he read that scripture, he read the belief that scripture. He
yeah.
Read the scripture. He knew his father had a prepared
yes.
So some of them read it and don't really apprehend it, but he knows this.
Yes.
He knows that he, and it tells you, the reward of a man that holds and serves all of them. Great is his reward.
Yes.
We don't have to worry about him. He's all right.
Yes.
All right. And if we stand today, we're not doing it. Listen to this here today. Because in that same scripture you used to read, what did it say? In my father's house.
Yeah, many.
A fifth.
Yeah.
And it wasn't so good at home. There is where we
can. Yeah.
Deaconess, if you would know.
Let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. and he's greatly to be praised. Can you just clap your hands and tell the Lord thank you? For this day.
Yes, sir.
I thank God for the life and the legacy of Brother Roy Lee Brown. I can still see him standing in the corner, just shouting and giving God praise.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen. You couldn't be next to Brown, because when he got on fire, you would catch fire as well. Amen. He just enjoyed church. I think Brown is one of very few who would not have a problem with being in church every day. Amen. Because he loved to praise God. At this time, I want to recognize all ministers and pastors. We thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to come and be with us here for this occasion. So if you will, please stand. Give us your name and your church affiliation if you choose to do so. It goes a little bit like this. Chris Ardwin, the pastor of the Second Union Church, Bunker, Louisiana. Also Greater St. James Opelousas. Pastors, preachers, will you stand and be recognized?
I'm Reverend M.W. Bennett. Pioneer Baptist Church, Dallas, Texas.
Reverend Larry Collins, St. John Baptist Church out of Four Corners, Louisiana.
All right.
Reverend Carl Thomas from the Salem Missionary Baptist Church, where Greg Jackson is pastor.
Amen.
Ananias Robin, my son, joining the Union Chapel Baptist Church for a short bit. See, Deacon Williams this morning.
Thanks for coming.
Thank you. All right. I believe we're going to hear from Sister Shirley. Brother Brown would get excited. And I would have to break out with something like, I get joy when I think about what's happening. I get joy when I think about. I get joy when I think about.
Thanks be to God.
Yes.
in his infinite wisdom, we are here at this appointed time.
Yes.
And on our side of humanity, certainly, it's understandable that we hurt, that we feel lost, and that's all right. Jesus showed us that.
Because
even in his tenure down here, we saw where he wept at the mourning of his friend. We saw where he experienced all of the emotions that we deal with here in this earth realm. And so he understands. We have not a high priest that does not understand. And we are thankful that he has made provision for us because he said, I go that the comforter might come. And so it is that we can find comfort through the power of the Holy Spirit. We can find strength from the word of God. And we can find encouragement from the people of God. And so I say to this family, my family, and the Second Union family who is going through this as well, you know, one of the things that we certainly can take comfort in is the fact that Brother Brown was ready. He was prepared. And his preparedness was a result of a blessed assurance that he had coming from the relationship that he had with the Lord Jesus. So he was prepared and ready to go. And while that you know, we can take comfort in the fact of this, because sometimes on this journey we find ourselves in life where we have to, we get something unexpected, some unexpected twist and turn, and we have to hurriedly try to get it together and get there all at the same time. But it's so much better when you have had time to get things. It's so much better when you know that you've got everything laid out and everything packed, and that you can take your time and you can move in confidence and know that as long as you've got the protection and the means of transportation to get there, you've got everything else lined up. And that was the case with our brother. He had everything packed up and ready to go. All he needed was the weight. And Jesus did that. He took care of that. And so we can rejoice and be glad about the fact that he's made a safe arrival. The question yet remains for us. Are we prepared for the journey? God bless you and keep you. And we will be praying for you in the days to come.
Through me.
The black,
the good looking,
yes,
and the God help them. All have to die. But dying is not bad in the life of a Christian. Because in the life of a Christian, death is your friend. Death crosses you from labor to reward. Amen. And when the battle is over, I want to see Jesus for myself. I'm going to miss Brown. He was a wonderful person, a great encourager, and a very good supporter of his pastor. It's so good when you don't have to stand up here and tell a lie. I know some people who lie on you when you're living, and they lie for you when you're dead. I don't practice lying. So if it wasn't so, I would just say, Lord, have mercy. Brown has been a wonderful, wonderful help in many situations. When Brown and I talked about the church and business of the church, his response to me was always, Rev, you're the pastor. I think sometimes we need to be reminded. As Brother Brown would say, Rev, you're the pastor. And he was a good follower. You know, we've got some sheep. And the sheep gonna follow the shepherd. But you got some goats. And you know the goat, all the goat's gonna do is buck. Everything you say, everything you do, they gonna just buck. That's what a goat is meant to do. Amen. Buck. But the Lord said you got to let the wheat and the tare grow together.
Right now.
And he said, when I come,
yeah,
I'll do the separating. And he's certainly a deacon I'm going to miss. Him and I were sick around the same time. And I remember calling and checking up on him. I went to the hospital a few times. I remember being there praying for him. And Brother Brown was a type when you would pray, he wouldn't let you pray by yourself. Amen. I'm at the hospital praying for Brother Brown. And as I'm praying for Brother Brown, I said, Lord, touch Brother Brown. Brown prayed and said, Lord, touch Rev. Amen. I pray, Lord, lay your hands on him. Brown said, Lord, lay your hands on Rev. Amen. We prayed together. And he was one, as it was said, and y'all all told the truth. Thank you. He was one who loved everybody. He was so concerned about his poor little sister.
Yeah,
Doris, you know this?
Yeah, Doris.
You could never tell. Amen. He was so concerned about his sister. Mona, he loved you. His sons, he loved you. His entire family. The mother of our church, Sister Annie. His aunts, God bless you, y'all all looking good. If Naomi wasn't here, I would see which one of y'all would ride with me looking good. Hey, y'all looking good. God is keeping you. Amen. Thank the Lord for a praying family. It has been said how he loved Sunday school. He loved sharing the word of God. Brother Calvin Washington, our deacons, y'all have done a beautiful job. And he certainly loved, let not your heart be troubled. And I believe his favorite verse was, God so loved the world. And you know, I said it, I preached it, But I don't know if I could say it like Brown.
Yeah.
Brown would just start, "God so loved the world," and the whole church would get excited.
Right.
I got a preacher almost falling down, and they don't get excited like they did with Brown. Turn with me briefly. Preachers, pastors, thank all of you for your presence. Thank you for being here. All our members and friends, it is certain that this church won't be the same again. 2 Timothy chapter 4. With all of these preachers and pastors, I get the feeling preaching won't be hard today. I won't have to beg. I won't have to buy a witness today. Nobody else say amen. My wife ought to be back there. 2 Timothy chapter 4, beginning with verse number 6. Are you there? "For I am already being poured out like a drink offering, and the time for my departure is near. I have fought a good fight."
Yeah.
The only fight a Christian ought to fight is the good fight of faith.
Yeah.
We need to learn to stop fighting each other. "I have finished my race. I have kept the faith." Sick in the hospital. He kept the faith. Burdened and in pain, but he kept the faith. "Now there is laid up for me a crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give me on that day."
Yes.
"And not to me only,"
yeah,
"but unto all them,"
yes,
"that love his appearing."
Oh, yeah.
God bless you. You may be seated. For just a few minutes, I want to speak from the subject, "Are you ready to go home?" Are you ready to go home? We know about yesterday. We know about today. But as Sister Charvette said, we don't know about tomorrow. You're doing good today. Some of you got it going on. But have you thought about a sick day? Maybe just around the corner. One thing is for certain is the fact that life is uncertain.
Yes, sir.
The word teaches us that no man knows the day nor the hour.
That's right.
When the Son of Man will come. But he gave us instructions, and it is to be ready.
Be ready.
There are times when I leave a little earlier from the house than Naomi does, and you know, y'all women got to make sure everything is in the right place, and we just on our nerves. And we don't want to say nothing because it's going to start an argument. So, I'll go do what I got to do, and I'll tell Naomi when I get home, "Be ready." I get home, guess what happens? She ain't ready. But heaven is a place where we have to make some preparation. There are six calls in life. The first call is a call of conception. When we were yet a substance in our mother's womb.
The second call is a call of birth. Job said in the 14th chapter, the first verse, he says, man that is born of a woman is but for a few days and full of trouble.
Yes.
The third call is a call of regeneration. John 3, verse 3, Jesus tells Nicodemus, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. The fourth call is a call of transformation. Romans 12 and 2 says, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. The fifth call is a call of death. Hebrews 9 and 27, it is an appointed time.
Yes, it is.
For man to die.
Yeah.
You can cancel an appointment with your hairdresser. You can cancel an appointment with your doctor. You can even cancel an appointment with your spouse.
Right now.
But this is an appointment we all must keep. There is the sixth call. The sixth call is a call of judgment. 2 Corinthians 5 and 10 says, we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ and give an account for the deeds that are done in our bodies. There are six calls in life. Deacon Roy Lee Brown, a brother, a companion, a father, a grandfather, a teacher, a counselor, a faithful servant of the Lord. He has now completed the circle, leaving from his mother's womb, impacting the world, and finally in God's presence. But in honor for him to be able to accomplish this task, he had to be ready to go home. In 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 6 through verse 8, Paul issues his charge in the light of his impending death. Timothy is to fulfill his ministry. And here Paul reflects on his own ministry. Here we find some powerful words to all Christians about loving and serving Jesus until the end of our days. You know, it's not how you start. Some of us start off good. And it's not how you start, but it's how you finish. The first thing I see is the present. Verse 6, Paul speaks of dying and departing. He says, I'm ready, being poured out as a drink offering. The image of sacrifice Paul uses is drawn from the Old Testament sacrificial system. During the ritual of sacrificing a lamb, wine was poured out at the base of the altar. Paul is using this image to refer to the type of death he was expecting. Because Roman citizens could not be crucified, he anticipated being beheaded. In which case, his blood would splash like wine on the ground. This pouring out of his life would be an offering of worship to Jesus. Paul adds the time Sometimes we show up on Sunday, amen, out of routine. We go to church just to go to church, but nothing changes in our lives. We 20 years ago we were no good. Today we still no good. The word says, if any man be in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things become new. There ought to be a change in your life. And you know what I like about Paul, when he was a devil, he was a good devil. Some of you devils don't know how to be good devils. He was a good devil, but when he became a saint, he became one of the best saints there ever was.
That's right. That's
right.
Paul didn't have a problem with God, but he had a problem with Jesus.
Right now.
No, he didn't have a problem with God. He was religious, but he was religiously lost. Some of y'all got a whole lot of religion.
Yeah.
But you can take your religion and you can find yourself in hell.
Uh-huh.
You don't need to be religious, you need to be saved.
Uh-huh.
Y'all ain't saying nothing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Folks ask you what you are. Stop sounding your trumpet. Catholic, Baptist, amen. Apostolic. We done got so confused. Some of us are non-denomination. When they ask you who you are, you ought to be able to tell them you're a Christian. You're a child of the King.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
Because religion is just another way of keeping us separated and segregated. Because when we get to heaven, there ain't gonna be one place for the Baptists. There ain't gonna be one place for the Catholics. There ain't gonna be one place for the sanctified. Nah, heaven is not a segregated place. Paul said, I'm now ready. How did this transformation occur? I'm glad you asked. Paul was on the right road. Do you remember a crooked man on the road called Straight?
Yeah.
He was on the right road. He was on the road of Damascus. And while he was on that road going to persecute the church, the Lord knocked him down.
Yeah.
I'll be through in a minute.
Yeah.
There are some people that ain't going to change until the Lord knock them down. Some people, their ways and their actions won't change until the Lord knocked them down. Sometimes you'll have to lay you flat on your back so you can look up and say, Lord, who are you?
Knocked
them down. Paul was a strong man. Knocked him from his beast. Paul looked up and said, Lord, who are you?
Yeah.
And he said, I'm Jesus.
Yeah.
I'm the one you persecute.
That's right.
Don't you know it's hard for you to kick against the prick? And Paul said, tell me what you want me to do. The Lord said, you keep going in the same direction.
Yeah.
But he said, I'm going to give you a different way. Some of you going in the right direction, you come to church.
Yeah.
Your motives all wrong.
Yes,
amen. You're going in the right direction, but God needs to give you a different motive. Some folks ain't happy unless there's mess in the church.
Come on. Yeah, that's
right. Some folks have left Second Union and went joined somewhere else because there was no mess here.
I know.
Y'all ain't saying nothing.
That's true.
Don't you know a dog bring a bone, a dog gonna carry a bone and you gonna keep a dirty y'all.
Come on.
Paul wasn't always ready. But let me tell you, it's impossible for you to ever have contact with Jesus and still be the same.
Come on with that.
That's right.
Something ought to change.
Yes, Lord.
Paul, at the time of my departure is close. The word translated departure is also used in Greek literature for the loosing of a ship from the dock.
Yeah.
Or a soldier loosening the stakes of his tent.
Yeah.
The image of a boat is indeed a beautiful image. Paul lifting the anchor, tossing the rope aside, and joyfully sailing to a better place. Oh yes, that The believer never dies.
That's right.
He just departs.
Yeah.
No, the believer never dies. Everybody in the cemetery is not dead.
Yeah.
Now, a lot of them were just asleep.
All right.
You ever worked hard? I mean, really worked hard. Amen. Took your shower and went to bed and you slept so sound. Amen. You didn't hear nothing. You slept and you didn't even dream. You were just sleeping.
Yeah.
Amen. And in the morning that alarm clock went off.
Hallelujah.
And you woke up. So it is in the life of a Christian. Amen. We'll lay down and we'll sleep. And when God tells Gabriel, put one foot on the water, put the other on the land, sound his trumpet, the dead in Christ shall rise. I done died one time.
Come on.
I'm not going to die anymore.
That's right.
I died from sin to righteousness.
Yes.
Paul longed for this final ultimate voyage. He told the Philippians in chapter 1, verse 23, he said, I have a desire to depart and be with Christ. That's what Brother Brown kept saying. He said, I'm ready now. That's what Brother Brown kept saying. I'm tired and my soul needs rest.
Yes,
I'm ready. Amen. My brothers and sisters, we all need to be ready.
Yeah. That's right.
And if you're not ready, then you need to get ready.
That's right.
Because sooner or later, our time will come. I didn't call enough hell down here.
That's right. Yeah.
I don't want to die and go to a worse place. Yes, Paul says, I have a desire to depart and be with Christ. Why? Because it is far better. This was Paul's dream, and now the ship was about to leave. Paul was ready. The question is, are you ready? I used to hear the old saint say, 'Tis the old ship of Zion.
Yeah.
I never say, get on board.
Yeah.
I used to hear him say, there's no danger in God's waters.
Yeah.
You need to get on board.
Yes, that's so.
And just in case you're wondering, yes, who's the captain? They would remind you, King Jesus. Is our captain. So you need to get on board.
Yes,
not only do we see the present, but secondly, we see the past. Paul looks back on his life with triumph. And he uses three more words associated with victory. First, he uses the analogy of a fight. He said, I fought a good fight. Paul was a warrior. Yes, he was not physically impressive, but he was a spiritual warrior.
Yes, sir.
He stood before Felix.
Yes, sir.
He stood before King Agrippa. He stood before the Roman soldiers with courage. Yes, Paul was such a warrior that when Paul gave his testimony, King Agrippa said, you almost persuaded me to be a Christian. Yes, and I believe we all ought to have a testimony. beyond what human eyes could see.
Yes,
yes, he writes for, yes, our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against rulers, against, yes, the powers of darkness, and against spiritual wickedness in high places. Have I got a witness?
Yes, sir.
Secondly, Paul says, I finished the race.
Yes, sir.
I love how Paul says, I finished the race.
Yes.
Understand, Paul did not say, I won the race.
Yes.
But he said, I finished the race. Yes, my dear, it doesn't matter if you fast or you last. What matters is you finish the race. Sometimes you may get wounded, but you've got to finish the race. Sometimes you might have to cry, but you've got to finish the race. Yeah. brother.
Yes.
You deserve your rest.
Yes.
We'll meet again.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
On the other side.
Yes, sir.
Can you give God a hand of praise? I want to be in the meeting. Yes. I want to be in the meeting. Yes. I want to be in the meeting. When all the saints. Whoa, my God. Woo, from the right. Yes.
Shall we bow in a moment of prayer? God, we thank you for your grace and your mercy. Thank you for your loving kindness, which is more than enough. God, we thank you for the life and the legacy of Brother Roy Lee Brown. Thank you, Lord, for what you've done in and through his life. And now, God, I thank you because you saw fit to call him from labor to reward. And now, God, I pray for his children, his grandchildren. I pray for his sister. I pray for his nieces and nephews, his aunts, his uncles. I pray for every soul that is connected to him. And, God, I pray for this Second Union family. Fill the void in our lives. Link that chain back together. And, God, it is my prayer that you give us the strength and the courage to keep on living. We've gone as far as we can go. We've gone as far as we can go. And now, God, into thy hands we commit his spirit. In the name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
For as much as it had pleased the Almighty God in his wise providence to take unto himself the soul of Brother Deacon Roy Lee Brown Jr., we now commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, dust to dust, ashes to ashes. I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, right blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. They shall rest from their labor, and their works do follow them. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Rest, rule, and abide with us always and ever. We all said, Amen. Amen.
On behalf of the family of Mr. Rawley Brown, they would like to express their gratitude to each and every one of you who have come out today to help celebrate his life and also his legacy. We want to say to the friends of this family, continue to keep the family lifted up in your daily prayer. And to the family, we say unto you to look up to the hills which cometh your help, knowing that your help comes from the Lord. And not only shall you find help, you shall find joy, you shall find strength, you shall find peace. For truly there is no sorrow on earth that heaven cannot heal. We want to thank Pastor Alduin for the words that he said today. And it is my prayer that something that was said will help you all through the remainder of this process. To the Paul Bears, we thank you for your service that you have rendered and also the strength that you have shown on today. And to each and every one of you who have played a part into this homegoing celebration. And on behalf of Fort and Joseph Funeral, I want to thank you for allowing us to be of service during this time. We present to you the portfolio, which consists of the names of those who have come today, the acknowledgement cards, and also the cross. This will now conclude our committal graveside service. The family does ask that you will continue to fellowship with them in the fellowship hall for the repast. Amen.